I'm not entirely sure. So I'm not
I have seen them play. Last time they played Venia 1. Yeah. I want to see how Eric actually adapts to Venia's use of side B. Because every time he was in disadvantage, every time he was put above him, he would just side B and extend his combo.
Mm-hmm. It certainly seems reactable enough.
It is. It was more like he was just afraid to air dodge or like really put anything out there.
Mm-hmm. That's understandable. I mean, I'd say Greninja's frame trapping in 50-50 game is strong enough that he sort of instills that fear on principle, especially against someone like Venia, who very much demonstrates mastery of the character and ability to go on and get those confirms. But strong start so far. Mr. E making it very difficult to come down for free.
Yeah, definitely having control over most of this game. Mm-hmm. He's definitely had more openings. Venia definitely got like two openings and put him at 6-0.
Yep, that was a bit more of a risky upbeat than he really needed to take at that point. That was still pretty close to center stage, but gets him off. Right, it wasn't that. So I feel with the disjoints in this matchup, Lucina disjoints, of course, very clean, very solid, pretty unquestionable. But I think Greninja can still contest fairly well, as much as he needs to, because normally if you're playing Greninja, you're spacing out your fair or you're doing it out of confirms anyway. Nair is disjointed enough that you can contest if you're not like directly hitting Greninja. So the confirm off of the Nair, by the way. Yeah.
Nair up smash. Potent stuff.
So as far as hitting directly above her, Lucina doesn't actually have as quick of an option as she does for the left and right, which I feel is really important in this, where landing Nair will be a lot easier for Venia to go for.
Yeah, it's like you still don't want to be above Lucina by any means, because like she has like really good ground speed too, so she can really catch you falling from above.
Absolutely. The last thing you want to do is get baited into an air, and even if the landing lag isn't that bad, catching a Lucina F smash never, ever, ever feels good. Even from center stage, even from low percent, you're just like, no, don't do it to me again. All right, leading off stage.
Yeah, right now, Venia with the ledge trap.
Very
nice fair, yeah. Good patience. Okay, Greninja best played when he's playing really bait and punish. Like, oh,
falling bear.
Waiting a little too hard, actually.
No, it's all right. That's difficult to go for on a stage like this, too. Auto cancels being what they are for both of these characters, actually. Make it so that staying at that angle under the platform where you can be dropped down on and have a quick attack, it's really kind of risky, even if you're at lower percents.
Oh, yeah. It's very popular in this room. I see, like, everyone, you know, running off the platform doing a bear, running off the platform doing a bear, whatever.
Now, is it, I know for characters like Crom and Roy, it's up air. I assume it's the same with Marcina, that they want to go for up air to start their combos, yes? Or is it, I mean, because I know they
like
have
falling up air?
Yeah, falling up air.
Falling up air is a combo starter, but it's, like, kind of risky. I don't know.
Yes. I'm trying to remember, because I know
Lucina doesn't even have, like, the craziest combo. She just has, like, insane strings and, like, ridiculous ledge trapping. Like, when I'm on the ledge versus Lucina sometimes, it's just like, all right, like, I'm probably going to get hit, but how do I not die? Like,
yes. Giving up center stage again with these upbees, I assume he's trying to go for the surprise reversal, but both times he's been fairly far off the mark and given up a lot of important stage control and pressure to do so.
Ooh, they're going off stage.
Tries to catch him. Venia patient, and see, that's...
And back to center stage for Venia, yeah.
That's a really hard call to make, even if Venia makes it look really easy with non-hitbox recoveries like this. And then you have to make the call of, do I go earlier and try to get there before my opponent can? Do I wait it out and chance that maybe they'll commit real hard and take me out?
Eric keeps opting to try and go for these dares off stage instead of like kind of waiting at the ledge.
Yep. Because
I mean, he wants that kill.
Is Lucina's ledge pressure? I mean, she does have dare and she does have things like that, like
barely
turnaround bear.
Yeah. Would have been the game. Venia really good at coming down with like aggressive options. And
speaking
Venia
of aggressive,
can live that. Like, yeah, I love how Greninja can live that now.
Yeah,
that's gonna kill him.
Yes. All right, very clean. Nothing too particularly wacky there, except for Mr. E going for those reversals. I feel like he was very contained except for those, so I don't know if that was him cracking the
he definitely kind of like he wasn't really waiting at the ledge at the end there. I could see him maybe going for more down tilt instead of like run off there, because he was pretty much letting Venia get back to stage like almost free. If he got the dare though, you know, he dies.
That is
that's just like a timing thing really, and I know Mystery is definitely someone who like wants to get something like that down, because in his head he's like, I should hit him with this. So.
I feel you. And that really is the question, is can I get these? I wouldn't say dare at the ledge is a particularly hard commitment to make, but it does give off like, oh, okay, I'm not going to get to edgeguard if I miss this. I'm not going to have as good a ledge setup. The ledge setups will still be okay. They'll be very serviceable, but you do give up some of your pressure and some of your scarier play for that risk. So, okay, baited it out there. That's really interesting that he keeps going for that. He hasn't had any success rate, but he's not scared out of it, which is always a strong thing to do. You can't be scared out of a good option. See stuff like that.
Yeah, I know. I know he loves to go off with those uppies and even footstools.
Very, I'm not sure I would say it's hard to tech, but you can mix up the timing enough that it's, you've got to be really ready for it. Him off stage, choosing to reset to ledge, not getting too aggressive, but gets...
Wow, no, same way the first stock was gone last game, you know. Nair up smash. Yep. Easy stuff.
Yep. And Venia, like you said, playing back enough and sitting on all that stage control, because that's all he needed to do, you know? Lucina in disadvantage. Have a good juggle save back here. Let's see if she can get back.
Ooh, only two this time. Mm-hmm.
Does work his way back to center stage. All right. Dash dancing.
Yeah.
Does Greninja, because it looks like he, I don't know, he's sort of a big character, but it looks like he low profiles enough that that would be noteworthy in the matchup.
It's tough.
Yeah.
Greninja's low profiling is really good.
Yes. It looked like...
I was having a lot of trouble as Palutena. He's basically just too low for everything.
I assume he can like go under the Nair unless you wait to use it.
Just him running like is obnoxious.
Yeah, absolutely. Was that a smash? Okay. Mm. He definitely wants the kill. He's not messing around.
Fishy for that down smash a little bit. Mm-hmm. Gonna get Mystery a little bit extra damage.
Yeah. Mystery making it back.
He's playing it really patient. He definitely wants to just, like, you know, chip on damage as safely as possible right now.
Mm-hmm. And nice. Venia fishing fairies. More for the confirm here. Yep. Getting a little... Okay, that was real greedy.
Yeah, like, you know... Just pressing forward towards him with the Nair, not so bad, but the Dare, very cool.
Yep. Ooh, all right, wow. Confirm.
Down till up smash. That's very smash forward. never forget that.
If it works, if it's clean. Oh, yeah, mystery
it
again.
It definitely still works. It feels a little harder. I feel like the percents are different.
It just might be. Mystery still in bear. A juggle trying to work back to the stage from that upbeat.
Yeah, very scary. Venia definitely had like that landing mostly scouted. If he was just a little bit closer, he would have definitely got that up smash. Would have put Eric in a really bad spot.
Very difficult at the corner, works his way back.
Up tilt.
This is a really...
It's so scary. Will he dash attack? Let's
yeah,
see.
Yeah, will he? Yep.
There's one. Wait. Yeah,
there it is. Nearly getting him with the fair. Ledge trap situation goes
Eric,
for the
Eric opting to, yeah, like, stay on ledge now. He definitely doesn't want to commit too hard on stage. Oh,
and notice
that he hasn't done yet, and I think he's saving. He's been saving it at least.
He's been using Shadow Sneak very sparingly. He's been really very reserved with his specials in general. The projectile.
That's good for you.
Wow.
Venia's face, like, oh. Yes, that works.
Oh my gosh.
Down tilt's still like such an amazing combo starter. Like down tilt up smash, down tilt fair, like.
And then,
you know a move is good when it has multiple kill confirms at multiple percent.
Yes. Do you think that was a case of bad DI? Because it looked like he was still trying to retreat there.
Let's see.
So if you look... So it looks like... Oh, no. Maybe he'd meant to buffer an option there for his DI, and then that had just gotten him... Oh.
Yeah,
maybe he
if he maybe turned around, if he had, you know, done the up tilt the other way, probably would hit him. But you could literally see the up tilt, like, the back of it just right about to hit him, and then, like, down tilt just comes out. It-